this was my final model, showing the facade and the beehive. Then there's a bath carved out at the bottom. All the rooms are cladded in the copper, which can then be used to waterproof the fabric. These holes cut out in the side would have glass, and the side walls are made out of concrete and fabric casted as well. They were cut out so that more light can pass down into the living areas here, and also so the buildings next door who have windows can see glimpses inside of the building. This is a sketch plan. This is the tailoring floor again. And this is the third floor with the bathroom and the bedroom and the wax jacket store. And this was a sketch section trying to figure out how I'd shade the fabric, going down into the bath and back up. And then these are the cutouts in the concrete which allow light into these two rooms next door. The jackets would be stored here. And then there's the waterproofing bath at the top. At the top of this, of the wax tunnel, there would be a glass panel which would allow sunlight to hit the wax, which would be stored here, to melt it all the way down to the bottom. And then there'd be a furnace at the bottom of the building which heated it up before the fabric ran through it. This is another section through the beehive. So the beehive would be through here, and there'd be almost swords which cut into the concrete which you pull out to get the wax off of the strips. This is the next section, trying to show the rollers in more details, and how it would pass through there and then around this room. In the fitting room, the fabric walls, the walls of the building would be made out of the fabric, so that you get your jacket is fitted in the room, inside a room where the fabric is. Okay, this is a diagram showing the circulation within the building. So this is the beehive where the bee circulates around. This is the fabric circulation. This is the tailoring floor, and that's the staircase which takes you from the tailoring floor. And this level here is the bathroom and bedroom and the wax jacket level. And this is the first floor, which is the fitting room and the living space there. Thank you. And yeah. Okay, these are my final drawings for the project. I found out that a lot of bees have this queen marking kit where they mark the queen bees for each year, and the numbers are really microscopic, so I decided I'd have a magnifying glass to read the keys and the numbering on my building. So this is the ground floor. So here's, if you can see over there, there's the entrance to the building here, and then the wax bath here, which collects the wax before the fabric rolls through it. Then this is the next floor. So you walk up this staircase here into the fitting room, which is cladded in the waterproofed fabric, and then you walk across here into the living space where the kitchen and a sofa will be, and then you walk up here to the next floor. All of these walls are fabric cast, and then they have the cutouts for the windows here. So when you arrive up onto this floor, you go into the bedroom, and there's a stair across here into the bathroom. This one here's the light passageway, this one's the wax tunnel, and that's the beehive at the bottom. From the bathroom you climb up into the storage room for the wax jackets, and then from there you go up into the tailoring workshop. And this is another version of this, but showing the fabric more clearly, and the jackets which are inhabited here, the bedroom, and then the bathroom there. This is the tailoring floor, so you enter the tailoring floor here, the fabric's collected here, and then you walk around here and this is where the tailoring and the jackets are sewn together, and this is where the fabric exits the building around the facade, and this is the staircase up to the rooftop. This is another version of that one showing the roller with the fabric travelling around and outside, and the fabric reappearing, jars of honey which are lined up, and then the tailoring desk here. And then there's a central atrium which allows light to go all the way through, so you can see glimpses of these passageways across and the fabric running through the middle of the building. This is the beehive and then the jacket stores there. There's also this idea that the green fabric would stain the building over time, so the copper would rust on the outside and you'd see like green markings around the building. This is one of the sections cutting through the wax tunnel. This is the copper cladding here and the entrance to the buildings here. Talbot Yard is this way and Borough High Street is in the backdrop there. So that's the jacket store, and this is the solar wax extractor which melts the wax all the way down. And then these are all the rollers which allow the fabric to travel around the building. And this is the final section, showing the actual inhabitation of the building. This is the fitting room where customers first enter into the building to have the jacket fitted. And then by the time they actually come back to collect their jacket, they might have had access all the way up to the top floor where the tailoring and waterproofing actually happens. And this is all the staining of the building, and this is the bath where the wax is kept. Here at the top is all of the beekeeping equipment, so he travels up here to the top of the beehive, and the bees can get food from the roof garden over here and also the hanging baskets here, and also they can travel a 1 mile radius around the building to get food. So yeah. That's my building. Okay.